Hey guys, so in this tutorial, we're going to look at how to do ribbon tracing. So how we can get particles to follow different parts of the body and create this really lovely ribbon effect. All right, so I'm going to get rid of this. The first thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to go into my FX folder and I'm just going to make a duplicate of the skeletal mesh emitter and the skeletal mesh system. If you haven't done this already, please refer to the previous tutorial, which I will put in the link below. I'm going to just get rid of this just so we don't get confused. I made that earlier. Okay. So I'm going to copy this guy and I'm going to rename this ribbon. And I'm going to go ahead and copy this guy. And I'm going to rename that ribbon as well. Okay, so let's get into the emitter first here. And the first thing I want to do is I'm going to scroll all the way down and I'm looking for the sprite renderer. And I'm going to get rid of that. And we actually have a built-in ribbon renderer, so we're going to bring that in. For material, we're looking for the default ribbon material. If you don't see that, just make sure you have everything checked off in your view options. I'm going to bring that in. And then we just need to update our system. So I'm going to get rid of this emitter. And I'm going to bring in the one I just created. And then, of course, I want to reset my user exposed variables. So I'm just going to set this up. Now this doesn't exactly give us ribbon tracing, but I do want to show it because I think it creates a pretty cool effect here. So I'm going to go ahead. First, I'm going to bring in my animation. So I brought in an avatar and some animation already. And then I'm going to grab that system. And here we go. And let's set the avatar. We're going to set the source. There we go. And now I have some pretty fun ribbons going on. So not ribbon tracing, we'll get there, but I think this is a pretty cool special effect to show off. All right, well, let's keep going. So the next thing we're going to need is I'm actually going to need a script. So I'm going to create a script and we'll call it ribbon script. So the first thing that we're going to need, of course, is our skeletal mesh. And so instead of using the reproduction sprite, we're going to be using this script to set the skeletal mesh. I'm going to get, I'm going to get the skinned bone data in the world system. And we're going to need a bone, which is an integer. So if we look at our skeleton really quick here, we have all of these names for all of the different bones inside our avatar. Each of these bones is affiliated with an integer. We're going to use a blueprint to convert name to integer, but from this point of view, we need that integer. So we're going to create a variable. So we're going to create an integer variable. We'll call it bone. And later inside a blueprint, we will set this integer variable via one of the names of the bone. And then, of course, we'll set the position to the particle position. Okay. I'm going to give this a category. And let's go back to our emitter. So I can get rid of a few things here. I no longer need this reproduction sprite. Not going to need that anymore. And in spawn, I'm going to look at my ribbon category, make sure that library only is checked off, and I'm going to add my ribbon script. Oh, and I need to set my position. There we go. Okay. So now I have my ribbon script all set up. I'm just going to set a default, but really we're going to be setting this in a blueprint in a second. And then in my emitter update, I no longer want the spawn burst instantaneous. For ribbon tracing, we're gonna want spawn rate. And I'll do, 100. Okay. The last thing I'm going to need here is I'm going to need initialize ribbon. And so I no longer need initialize particle. And let's move this above ribbon script. Awesome. I'm going to set the lifetime to 10. I'm going to set the color to this one. And ribbon width, that's kind of skinny. I'm going to go with 15. Okay, and we should be all set. So let's move on to our system. So we already have that skeletal mesh variable. So let's set it. And now I need a variable for the bone, which is, as we might remember, an integer. And let's go ahead and set that. Okay, so now we should be all set there. So what I need to do is I need to get an integer of the bone based off of one of the bones in my avatar. And to do that, we're going to use a blueprint. So I'm going to go into my blueprints folder and I'm going to make a new blueprint. Call it BP ribbon. And I'm going to bring in a skeletal mesh. And let's go ahead and set up our skeletal mesh. We're going to be using an animation asset, which I already imported into my project. And there we go. Now, you don't have to make it invisible, but I like the effect of just the ribbons and not seeing the avatar. But maybe for now, we'll keep it just to show what's happening here. Okay, and then I'm going to bring in a Niagara particle system. Notice that the indentation, that this is a child of the skeletal mesh, that's important. And we're going to set our system here to ribbon. Okay. So we don't need to set the skeletal mesh. By default, it's going to look for the parent, which we already have set up. Okay, and we already have this ribbon going. So the bone by default is set to 0, which is in this case the hips. But if you wanted to change it to something else, what we're going to do is bring in the skeletal mesh and we're going to do get bone index. And we're going to be getting the index of a bone based off of the name. So if I go through and let's say I wanted the left foot, I can just put in left foot. It is case sensitive, so be mindful of how they write it out here. And now I'm going to bring in my particle system and I'm going to say set Niagara variable. We're going to set the bone variable, which was an integer. The variable name was bone. And there's my value. And we can do this right away. Great. So now we're going to have that trail coming off of the left foot. So let's actually go into a little lighter of a, there we go. Now I can see. And I'm going to bring in that blueprint. And now once that foot starts moving, we have a trail. There we go. I'm going to do the hand because I feel like that moves a bit more. It's going to really highlight my point here. There we go. Now I have this really nice trail. Great. So let's say you wanted to do like both hands and both feet and the head. So if we go back into our blueprint here, we can just set up an array of all of the bones that we want to use. So I'm going to set up a variable called bones. We're going to be using name since this takes a name. And to switch a variable to an array, we're just going to do that. I'm going to compile so I can set up my default values, and I'm going to do head. So let's see. Yeah, head and left foot and right foot, right hand, left hand. Okay. So right foot and left foot and right hand and left hand. Okay, so now that I have that as an array, I'm going to go ahead and loop through this array. So I'm going to do a for each loop, and we're going to switch this over. There we go. And now for each name, we're going to do get bone index from our skeletal mesh. And I'm going to need to spawn a new Niagara system for each of these bones. I'm going to delete this, actually. And we are going to spawn system attached. We're going to set up this template to be ribbon. There we go. And then we're going to use the latest system that we just spawned to set the Niagara variable, which variable name is still bone. We're still getting the value from here. And we just need to make sure that our skeletal mesh is the one we're attaching to. So because we're attaching to the skeletal mesh, it's going to automatically set the SK mesh to what we have in the blueprint, since this will be a child of this. Okay, so let's give that a shot. And there we go. I have 5 trails, 1 for each of the feet, 1 for each of the hands, and 1 for the head. Now I have this happy little ribbon trail madness thing happening. Cool. So I hope you give that a shot. I hope you have some fun, and be sure to subscribe to my channel, and I'll have cool videos coming out soon.